Shalom, Kohalo, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rachak, Wadash. It's given all praise to the Most High, name of His only begotten Son, name of the Holy Spirit, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, which is bless you to the Most High and bless you to His only to His Son in their true names. Double honors to our teachers, the elders and apostles, the great millstone who taught us His truth and truth and sincerity. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. Shalom to the 144,000. My name is Ibar from the Prophets in Babylon camp down here in Tampa, Florida. And quick, I want to go into this comment I saw one of the brothers post. It was a comment that somebody shared, I guess. And we're gonna read it. It says, went on a date with a girl who I thought was single, and to be honest, it went really well. We ended up hanging out until super late, maybe 3 a.m., just chatting. Then she gets a phone call and says, hold on, it's my husband. Just give me a few minutes. Just give me a few. And she answered and imitates the most believable sleepy voice I've ever heard, telling him how she was just thinking about him and she'll call him and talk to him later, even added a little mumble. I was just shocked the way she got off the phone and acted like everything was normal, even trying to resume the conversation we were having was crazy. She even wanted to invite me inside, but to be honest, I just couldn't do it. I ended up asking a few things about him, and turns out the guy is overseas and trains soldiers for combat. Did a couple tours. It's like I did a couple tours myself. I ghosted her, and about a week later, she starts asking me why I'm acting weird, and she thought things were going well. I told her the only thing weird here is a woman willing to destroy her husband's sanity and well-being while he's risking his life to keep the lights on for such an ungrateful parasite. All right. I mean, this as a post, but I figured I'd just touch on it real quick because this shows you how careless and evil and wicked these women can be. You know, this man is over here risking his life to, you know, pay the bills, you know, because that is a job, you know, and she's over here, you know, about to invite this man in, and that's the thing. We live in a very adulterous generation, so these women, they won't even tell you that they got a man. That's why you gotta be mindful. You know, that's why we know when you talk to for you brothers out there that don't have women, when you talk to women, you gotta always ask them, you know, do you have a man? You know, that's supposed to be the first question that you ask. And if they say no, whether you feel like they lying or telling the truth, and you gotta take that, you know, and leave that, you know, take that and leave her where she at. Because you go to deal with these women, you know, and they got a man, you know. Not only are you committing adultery, but you are because that's a sin unto death. You are in danger of death. You know, if that guy would have went inside there, you know, her husband. Well, I mean, I guess he was overseas, but in another situation, the man will come home and, you know. You get caught, and you know, now this guy, you know, scripture talk about the jealousy of a man. All right, so be mindful of this, man. Also, when you go out, you know, Jake be going to the club and to all these parties and shit, and you talking to a woman, you know, or even may start dealing with a woman the whole time she got another man. So be mindful of this, man. Don't get caught up out here, you know, chasing some you know, chasing some ass. Quite frankly, all right, and this guy did the right thing, all right. So it says, Exodus chapter 20, verse 14, thou shalt not commit adultery. Okay, so it is forbidden for us to commit adultery. You should not be in the spirit of committing adultery. And nowadays, if you ask a woman if she got a man, you know, she'll say that's lame. Like, what's that damn demon named Jess Hilarious? She was asking what's his name, Chico Bean. That comedian, you know, I guess she was trying to get with him, but she had a whole man, you know, and these women that do that, they'll have a whole man, but because he is not exciting anymore, they want to go for something, you know, something else, All right, and this is why you got to be mindful of these evil, wicked women. All right, and don't get caught up in their traps and snares. Also, if you got a woman, you got to watch your woman. Make sure she ain't doing it. Because these women are susceptible to Satan. Scripture says they are the weaker vessel. They are susceptible to Satan, so Satan can jump on them and make them do something, you know. Or, you know, Scripture says keep her in straitly. You ain't supposed to have, let your woman go out and roam the town with her whole with her whole friends. All right, because then, you know, she will trespass against you. And Scripture says, marvel not. It says, Proverbs chapter 6, verse 20, verse 32. It says, but whoso committeth adultery with a woman lacketh understanding. He that doeth it destroyeth his own soul. Right? So if you know, commit adultery with a woman, you destroy your own soul because the Lord's going to judge you. It says, but the man who commits adultery with an utter fool, for he destroys himself. Oh, it's like it is an utter fool. For he destroys himself, and there's too much adultery going around in this, you know, in this generation. This is an adulterous generation, you know. But that woman, she, you know, she played that, you know, she played that. And if a woman do that in front of you, she'll do that to you. She'll do it to somebody else in front of you. She'll do it to you. But she played that damn role in front of this man, you know, and put on that show, you know, which these women are, you know, very deceitful. She put on that damn show. And you know, if he was less of a man, you know, he would have went through with it. But he did the right thing and said, nah, and I ain't doing that. All right, but you know, another, you know, a damn nigga will take any opportunity he can get. You know, even in the world, bro. I knew Jake that would you know, pass each other's girls back and forth. Just complete wickedness, man. You don't do that shit, you know. Me personally, bro, no friend I've ever had. I've never looked at a woman. I don't want that woman. I never got with another friend's woman, or even my enemies. Say I had beef with somebody in the world, and they break up with that girl. I ain't gonna try to go, you know. And niggas do that, man. But that's a wicked and you know, demonic spirit to do that, man. Okay, first of all, and it's a homosexual spirit. Why would you want to be with a woman? Kissing all up on her and, you know, touching all, you know, what another man has already, you know, all you're doing is, that's why they call it sloppy seconds. That's evil. It says, verse 33, anyone when I dealt with, you know, I you know, I dealt with women who was either new around or, you know, new to school and who I didn't know, you know, who the exes was. You know, I can't, you know, look at a bitch macking on a nigga and then the next week I'm macking on the bitch. That shit, you know, that shit don't sit right. It says, a wound and dishonor shall he get, and his reproach shall not be wiped away. Right? Cause that's a nigga. You know, when you see a motherfucker doing that, you know that's a nigga. You know, and you gonna start to look at him differently. It says, for jealousy is the rage of a man, therefore he will not spare in the day of vengeance. And that's what happens. A man get you know, you know, even our Lord is a jealous power. Well, he's jealous over his woman, which is the, you know, the elect of Israel, same way we are over our women. Okay, so, and if a woman goes and plays the harlot, you know, you know, really you can't deal with her anymore. Okay, it says Ecclesiastes chapter 26 verse 22, and harlot shall be counted as spittle, but a married woman is a tower against death to her husband. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man, and this is what happens. This is why a lot of you niggas, you get these wicked ass women, because you a wicked ass nigga, man. You know, you might have been a guy that was committing adultery, you know, trying to sleep, or if not sleeping with your best friend woman, you know. So it says, but a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. And you got brothers out there that got women that's, you know, they ain't perfect, but, you know, they, for the most part, you know, they ain't a headache. You know, they are a helpmeet. You know, if you got a woman and you clean the, you know, cleaning the clothes and washing the dishes and cooking the food, and she's sitting on her ass on her phone, you know, chatting it up with other niggas, hey, you got a wicked woman. Okay. It says, a dishonest woman content of shame, but an honest woman will reverence her husband. You see? So that woman, she content of shame, but an honest woman, she would have reverenced her husband. It's not, she wouldn't have been there in the first place. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog, which is a BITCH, but she that is shamefaced will fear the Lord. A woman that honoreth her husband shall be judged wise of all, but she that dishonoreth him in her pride shall be counted ungodly of all. And that's what that woman did. She dishonored her husband. You know? Let me grab this and I'll close out. Because, you know, the way she got on that phone and put on that show. It's a lock here. She got on the phone and put on that show. It shows you that her as is demonic. You know, and then she tried to act like it was nothing after the phone call. Proverbs chapter 30, verse 18. And that was probably a decent guy. He probably was trying to take her seriously. You know, he said they was talking at 3 a.m. Most guys ain't talking at 3 a.m. You know? So he was probably trying to really get to know her and, you know, deal with her. And it didn't, you know, told time she was a demon. And that's what it's like out here nowadays. So if you got a woman, you know, keep your woman rather than, you know, going out looking for something else, because you're going to find even worse. Proverbs 30, verse 18, there be three things which are too wonderful for me, yeah, for which I know not. The way of an angel, it's like the way of an angel, it's like the way of an eagle in the air, the way of a serpent upon a rock, and the way of a ship in the midst of the sea, and the way of a man with a maid. So the way of a man and his woman. It says, such is the way of an adulterous woman. She eateth and wipeth her mouth and saith, I have done no wickedness. And that's what that woman did. You know, she ate, she was eating. Let's lock you. Let me get up out of here. So it says, such is the way of an adulterous woman. Okay, a harlot. So she eateth and wipeth her mouth and saith, I have done no wickedness. So, you know, imagine if that man would have went inside of there, you know, she would have been eaten, okay, and you know what, all right? Then she would have wiped her mouth and said she ain't do no wrong. She would have called her husband after that and act like nothing happened. And a lot of these women be getting popped while they're on the phone with their husband and stuff, man. So this is a wicked and adulterous world, bro. We need the Yahusha to deliver us out of this wicked place, and that's what we hope for. Shalom, come and show our love, blah, blah, blah.